musicians and stuff like that. So it's just a little bit more respectful. So I just worked through that five finger scale, right hand and left hand. Now, there's some things to pay attention to on this five finger scale. Now you can just like, you know, like just play it like crap, basically, all right, and garbage. Or you could start to like really start to hone in and focus on the five finger scale and start to think about it from a technical standpoint and really how can you get better at your technique using this scale. So much of learning how to get better at technique is really just awareness. It's awareness of what it is that your body's doing, how you're feeling, how you're holding your arms, your body, your feet, all of that stuff. It's awareness of what's going on with your body mechanics, okay? Super, super important. So let's just like take a look at some of this awareness stuff. So we have our five notes, right, of our five-finger scale. So you notice what I put down at the bottom here. Try different articulations, tempo, and dynamics, okay? So try different articulations, tempo, or tempi, and dynamics, okay? So articulations, well, what can I do? I could play legato. And you also notice that, can you hear that like accent I have on the first note and the last note? Now you don't want to do this. That's a little bit too much, but just a little. Now, this is a legato articulation, right? All smooth and connected. What about staccato? That's a legato. Staccato. Legato. Okay. Now, you can do that in major. You can also do it in minor. Legato, staccato. Okay, different tempo. Obviously, you can go slower, you can go faster. I don't need to demonstrate that. And then the other one was dynamics. Okay, so you can go staccato soft, staccato forte. Now, you might find that that's at first a little, whoa, wait a minute, that's a little challenging to do that, okay? Anytime you find something that's like, oh, wait a second, that just took me a second. Ah, that's great. That tells you that, oh, I got to work on that a little bit, all right? If it's not immediate that, oh, yeah, I could just move in between all of these, no problem, then that lets you know, oh, I should probably put a little bit of time into this. Now, I just did this in C major and C minor. Guess what? You could do it in G major, G minor, okay, F major, F minor. You could go on to the black notes. Now, this, when we talk later on about the key bed and deeper in the key bed, I'll come back to that, all right? But just think about, like, still, five finger, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here in the right hand. Okay, so back to C. So that's all pretty, you know, basic of sorts, right? So you could just, you know, do your five finger scale, up and down, slow, fast, medium, different articulations, legato, staccato, and different dynamics. Now you can start to, if you want to get a little bit more advanced with it, okay, well now could you do staccato in the right hand while doing legato in the left hand? Switch it. Now there, I can feel tension being created in my hand. That lets me know that I would have to work on that, okay? Anytime I have tension in my hand, my arms, guess what? That's a pretty good indicator that, you know, you gotta practice that more. Remember, with tension, first of all, if you are a member of PianoWithWilly.com, make sure that you take a look at the pain, tension, and technique lesson. Perhaps one of the most important lessons that I've ever done, okay? Really talks about the grab technique, talks about body mechanics. Super, super important to make sure that you don't get hurt at the piano and to make sure that you're using good technique, okay? Now, That lets me know, like that little tension that's created lets me know that, hey, you know, you should work on that a little bit, okay? And you can add it to the list of, you know, 1,000 other things to work on. But let's talk about that for a second. You got 1,000 things to work on. All right, you can get overwhelmed and bummed out that you got 1,000 things to work on, or you could say, okay, well, you know what, let me just work on this one today, okay? So that's what you do. You pick one, you work at it. Where students end up going wrong or end up failing is that they never take one thing and work on it, and they're just constantly like in this constant perpetual motion of moving from one thing to another to another. Make that look a little nicer there. Moving from one thing to another, all right, and never sticking with one thing. So stick with one thing, you know, find this one thing, and then maybe that's what you practice today, tomorrow, and the next day, all right? So that was one idea, like doing legato with one hand, staccato with the other hand. What about dynamics? Could you play like loud in the left hand while playing soft in the right hand? And then change that. I think you would find that to be a very interesting exercise and very difficult to pull off. But that's what you want to do to be able to bring out that melody and whatnot, is to be able to play that left hand softer and play the right hand a little bit louder, right? And of course it goes on and on and on from there. So like you could try different tempos, of course, you know, like maybe do quarter notes in one hand, eighth notes in the other hand, something like that. Something like that. So you could also try doing major in one hand, doing major in the right hand, doing minor in the left hand, doing contrary motion. So really, it's really left to your imagination. And the only limitation in terms of exercises is really limited to your own imagination. So whatever you can imagine, you could start to come up with and create some exercises. Now, I'm going to show you an exercise later on that's really complicated and really kind of cool, and we'll kind of talk about that a little bit more. So let's move on, all right, so we don't get too bogged down. All right, now, this, super important. Do piano essentials first, okay? So after you do the five finger scales, the next thing before moving on to any of the other things that I'm going to talk about in this technique builder is do your piano essentials. Now, I don't know if you're familiar with it or not, but I created this program called Piano Essentials. And quite honestly, I think it's really kind of one of the best programs I've ever created. Each key has this really cool, like, sheet, this one-page sheet, okay, that, like I said, there's one for each key. You got a nice colored circle of fifths and all that. And it goes through the major scale, goes through your related minor, goes through a bunch of different chords and all that. And this program is available to all students at Piano at Willie. And I, of course, go through video as well. So I you know, show you like, okay, you know, so like, you're like, here's your major scale. But then I also give you a bunch of different techniques that you could do, like showing you, like, play the example, play rootless chords, you know, and I go through and give you examples of all of this stuff. So you have a real nice step-by-step laid out plan for how to practice your major scales. Let me stop there for 1 second. I find that 99% of students, okay, might even be higher than that, because I have yet to really find a student that knows all 12 major scales. So, Willie, what does it mean to know all 12 major scales? First of all, when I say scale, it's the same thing as saying key. So it's really knowing all 12 major keys, all 12 major scales. So knowing a scale is this. Let's say I'm going to take the key of D. All right? It means that I can play that scale contrary motion. All right? I don't have to look at it either. I can play it without looking at it. All right? I know that there are two sharps in the key of D, F sharp and C sharp. I know that the fifth is A, the 13th is B, the sharp 9 is